Hello friends, welcome to our channel SS Unitech, and my name is Vipul. Today I am going to unbox the Redmi Note 5. Xiaomi introduced two segments in Note 5 series. First one is Note 5 and the other one is Note 5 Pro. Today we are having with us Note 5 with 3GB RAM and 32GB. Let's take a look on the box. The front end side, it is showing that it is from MI, which is the a logo of Xiaomi, and on the bottom of the box the name of the device is mentioned, which is Redmi Note 5 by Xiaomi. And on the side there is device name mentioned, Redmi Note 5. On the top of the box there is nothing, and on the left side again the name mentioned, and the bottom there is nothing. On the back side of the box the main specification of the device are provided. And we are having black variant with 3GB RAM and 32GB ROM. And the USP of the product would be 5.99 inch screen, which is of 18:9 aspect ratio. And we are also having front camera with selfie light. And it is having 4000 mAh high capacity battery. And it is also offering Snapdragon 625 octa-core processor, which is good in its price range. And these are the specifications on the box which are given. And as we can see, the MRP on the box is given 10,999, and on Flipkart it is available on 9,999 rupees. So I had ordered this device from Flipkart. Okay, now let's take a look inside the box, what's the accessories and how the product looks like. Okay, now we are opening it. So on the top of the box we are having this box, and it is having a plastic PU cover. Since we are having a black variant with us, so they have provided a dark PU cover with it, and it is quite flexible. And it is a fingerprint magnet, as we can see. And let's keep it aside. Now after that we are having the device with us. Let's keep it aside and check what else we get in the box. We are having some user manuals with us, and they are having all the information about the device. Let's keep them aside. We are having a SIM ejector pin with us. Let's take out, it is pretty much inside. And this is our SIM ejector pin. We are also having a charging data cable, and it looks like a normal data cable with us, with a good quality of the plastic with it, and it is having normal USB to micro USB port with it. And now most of the devices are coming with the type C port, so we are expecting that they must have given the type C port with it, which is not, it is a normal type C micro USB port. And what else we get in the box? And we are having a bulky charger, and it is having 5 amp and 2 volt. That means it is a normal charger, not a fast charger. So this time they also not provided any fast charger with the device. And we are not having any other accessory. Like always, they do not provide any earphone accessory with their devices. So let's keep them in the box. Now let's take a look at the physical overview of this device. On the top of the device we are having 3.5mm jack, and beside that there is one microphone, and we are also having one IR blaster with it. On the right of the side we are having volume rockers button and a separated power button with it. And on the bottom there we are having the micro charging port and two speaker grills, and I believe one of them must be a speaker and other one would be the microphone of the device. And on the left hand side of the phone we are having SIM card tray with it. Let's open it. Let's open the SIM card tray. So it is taking some time. And SIM tray is a dual SIM hybrid slot. That means it would be supporting either two nano SIM or one nano SIM and the other micro SD card with it. So let's put inside. On the back side, we are having 12 megapixel camera with 2.2 aperture and a dual tone LED light and a fingerprint sensor. And this time we are having a small bump in the camera side if it is visible in the video. And in the earlier version, I believe we were not having any bump in the camera. On the front and side, we are having a 5 megapixel camera with aperture f2.0, and we are having bunch of sensors with it. And as we can see, we are also having a pre-applied screen guard on the screen, which is a good thing. Nowadays, all the providers used to provide screen guard and PU case PU covers with it. Now, by the time the device takes first boot, the specifications are given on the screen. Phone has been boot up, and as we can see that it is having 5.99 inch, which is of 18:9 aspect ratio. And as we can see that top and bottom margins have been reduced to make the screen big, and it is looking quite nice and big. And the side view of the screen are quite good. Its base screen, which is MIUI 9, which is based on Nougat 7, and it is having on-screen navigation button for back, home and menu bar. Now check for the Android version in the system. Let's go to setting and check it out in the about phones. So we can see that it is having MIUI 9 version, and on which is based on Android version 7, which is Nougat. If we click on that, it is Android Nougat version. And it is having CPU of octa-core, which is clocked at 2.0 gigahertz. RAM is 3 GB, and out of 32 GB internal storage, it is providing us 23.98 GB available. So it is quite impressive phone in terms of specification and the hardware specification. So let's go to the home. There is not much to talk about its UI because it is same in all the devices. So now we have heard that they have improved their camera performance. So let's check out its camera, how this performs. So this is our camera. It is having like video mode, and it is also having some extra modes like normal, lamo, color, rustic, different modes. And on the top of the camera, it is showing SDR, which is disabled right now, and it is showing the flash, which is in auto mode, which is on mode by default. So let's set it to auto mode, and let's take its first pic. So shutter speed is quite fast, and it is autofocus. And right now we are clicking artificial lighting condition. That's why this photo seems very normal. And it is also providing tap to focus on the screen, and let's click. So now let's check out the photo quality. So in the low artificial lighting, camera quality is not that much good. And so these are some photo samples which have been taken. So this one taken by the front camera, which is not quite impressive in the artificial lighting condition. So in this phone, they have not upgraded that much. They just upgraded its screen size, which is 18:9. So as per me, if you want to upgrade your phone, so in the current condition, it would be good for the user. And it is having fingerprint. Let's set the fingerprint scanner. Go to settings, lock screen, add fingerprint pattern. So we are setting a pattern in it. Now setting the fingerprint. See, it is quite fast. So fingerprint has been set up. Now let's check how much time it will take to unlock the screen. Now I just accidentally touched the screen and it unlocked the phone. Now try again. And it's very fast. The fingerprint scanner is very good in terms of access and speed. So it is quite good and quite impressive, the fingerprint scanner. And if you guys want to compare the Redmi Note 4 and Redmi Note 5 in a detail, so please mention in the comments so that I would provide you the comparison between Redmi Note 4 and Note 5 in my next one. Guys, if you like my video, please subscribe and share to your friends. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Bye.